When you go to most masjids, you see something consistent. It's filled with old people. All those people who say, I'm going to practice Islam when I get older, yeah, they're there. Do you ever wonder why we don't have many senior citizen homes in the Muslim community? Because for many people, the masjid is the senior citizen home. The problem is that some of these old people that hang out the masjid aren't very friendly. Haram! Not much of a welcoming committee if you ask me. You see, the problem is that some of these old people are old school and their concept of being religious is being rigid. Well, in reality, if you study Prophet ﷺ, you see that he was fair, he was just, he was kind. He smiled a lot. But somehow, some way, in the last 1400 years, we've messed that up. And now what you see is people who think they're religious and they're just really the haram police.
Hey, little kid, what is your name? What are you doing?
My name is Ali. I'm 5 years old. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 5 years old. And I was 4 for a whole year. And then I became 5.
I didn't ask your age. I asked, what are you doing?
I don't know. I just want to play with my ball.
This is masjid. There is no playing in the masjid. Haram.
Sorry. Hey, can I play with my puzzle?
Puzzles? No, no, no puzzles. Puzzles have pieces. Pieces, not good. Islam is peace, not pieces.
Aww, really? I know what I can do. I can pretend. I like pretending.
There is no pretending in the masjid. You want to pretend? Go sit there and pretend to be quiet. That is how you pretend.
How did we get all these kids in the masjid?
What are these kids doing in the masjid? This is my home. My senior citizen home.
Haram. And then we wonder why our kids don't want to go to the masjid. But this isn't Islam. This is culture. Oftentimes when you see Muslims doing these weird things, that is 100% culture. This is not just the religion, but unfortunately people mix up the two together and they can't realize what's culture and what's religion. And that's why I say, Alhamdulillah, Allah showed me Islam before He showed me the Muslims. When we actually study Islam, we can see how the Prophet ﷺ shows how to treat children. And we're supposed to treat them with kindness and patience. It's very different than the way we're treating them today. For example, one time when the Prophet ﷺ was praying, he was in the position of sujood. That means his forehead was on the floor, and that means the people behind him had their forehead on the floor, and they're all praying. And usually it doesn't take that long to be in that position, but this time it was very, very long. Very, very long. To the point that one of the people praying behind them realized that something was wrong. Maybe he was receiving revelation. Maybe he had passed away. So the man did something very abnormal. He raised his head to see what was going on. And he saw the Prophet ﷺ and he saw his grandson. And what he saw made him smile. It was the kid riding the Prophet ﷺ like the way you ride your dad or mom when you're a kid. Like, you know, you're riding like a camel or a horse. He was riding him like that. And it made him smile and he put his head down. And the Prophet ﷺ took his time with the child, basically let him play. Why? Because a priority in that situation was to let him finish his playing before we, even as a group, finish our praying. It showed us in Islam which one's more important. Today, these days, we treat our kids not with patience or with kindness. Sometimes we're so tough on them, making ourselves a priority, while in reality, they are the priority. Ask yourself, did he yell at the child? No. Did he scream at the child? No. Did he give him a lecture on the importance of being respecting in the masjid? No. He let the kid play, because that's what little kids do. They play. Today, when we see little kids at the masjid, we want them to sit there like statues. Be quiet. Don't talk. Don't move. They're kids. They move. They talk. If your kid was at home and he wasn't moving, he wasn't talking, he was like this, you wouldn't be like happy. You'd be panicking. You'd be driving him to the hospital. What's wrong with my kid? Now, don't get me wrong, there's a lot of bad kids out there, but I'm not talking about those kids. I'm talking about those young, innocent ones that are so cutie, cutie, cutie. Yeah, don't be mean to those. And remember, these little kids have a free ticket to Jannah, to paradise. You and I don't have a free ticket to paradise because we're accountable for our actions. These little kids have no accountability. So I think it'd be a good idea to be like kind to those who are like, have a free ticket to paradise, don't you think? You and I don't have that. Unless, of course, you're a little kid watching this video and you're doing this.
Yes!
I'm a big kid, I'm doing this. Yes! So next time you see little kids playing at the masjid and they're not disturbing anyone, Let them play. Because those little kids that are playing today may one day be praying tomorrow. Not literally tomorrow. I mean like in the future. But I mean, there's nothing wrong with them praying tomorrow, but they don't have to. So you shouldn't be forcing them unless they want to do it. And that, yeah. One time my daughter told my wife that, oh, I don't need to pray. And my wife's like, why? I said, because my dad said I'm not accountable for it. And my wife's like, you see, this is what your videos teach your kids. And I'm like, so let's try to change the way we treat children at the masjid.
How about haram?
No. That's not going to work.
Halal?
Yes. Much better.
Halal, yes. I like it. But don't tell anyone I like it.
This is Ali reminding you just in case you forgot.